Troy Torres alleges that Tuncap personally visited the home of a well-known supporter of Senator Dennis Rodriguez Jr., asking for the supporter to relay a message to tell the lawmaker to vote in favor of the governor's tax hike bill, or he would not sign his now-running mate's, Dave Cruz, personal contract to teach ROTC students at JFK High School. Torres insinuates the contract needed to be signed in order for Cruz to be removed as a DOE classified employee so that his candidacy would not violate the Mini-Hatch Act. Torres not only wants an investigation into Tuncap, but is also calling for Lieutenant Governor Ray Tenorio to be disqualified as a gubernatorial candidate. Senator Dennis Rodriguez did not vote in the favor of the tax bill, although it passed by an 8-7 vote. This latest allegation follows a string of late night and early morning letters to island leaders alleging corruption by Adeloup. One of the latest ones came just minutes before last week's One Guam gubernatorial debate, in which he alleged that he did drugs with Lieutenant Governor candidate Josh Tenorio and later also with Lieutenant Governor Ray Tenorio, both of whom have strongly denied the allegations. Torres began making the allegations after his Lattie Heights home was raided, and he, along with two others, were subsequently arrested. No charges, however, have been filed, and instead Torres was issued a notice to appear in court in 2021. After his arrest, Torres resigned as the campaign chairman for Senator Rodriguez's gubernatorial bid. As for the latest complaint, GEC Executive Director Maria Pangilinan tells KUAM she has sent it to their legal counsel and to commissioners to determine whether the GEC or the Civil Service Commission will investigate. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Hyani Mendiola.